to cause you any sorrow. I never meant to cause you any pain. Only wanted one time to see you laughing. I only wanted to see you laughing in the purple rain, purple rain, purple rain, purple rain, purple rain, purple rain, purple rain.
How's everybody doing? All right. Thank you. Well, you might be wondering, why is this man dancing? And I got to tell you, there's a big reason why. Ladies and gentlemen, students, parents, guardians, the COVID positivity rate has been decreasing, and we're excited about that. If you look at our county numbers, they have been dropping. If you look in the Central Valley, they have been dropping. So we have some good news, not some solidified news, but some good news that hopefully everyone will feel good about. There is a likelihood that we can start a hybrid back in school learning very soon. You heard that right. I said, there's a good chance that very soon on the horizon, we will be able to come back in a hybrid format. That means in-person instruction for students. So I hope that makes you excited. Basically, what we're waiting on is as the numbers draw closer, as the numbers hit red, and we get word from Dr. Paul down at Madera County Public Health, those are the two things that we're waiting for to return to a hybrid format. So last week, we were getting pretty close there with our numbers to red. If we hit red and we get word from Madera County that we are eligible to return, that's when we are going to our hybrid plan. So what that means is 2 days a week, students will be on campus in their even and odd classes. We're going to be sending out a lot of materials to give you some specifics on that, what that's going to look like. But basically, in a nutshell, just for this video and this message today, what that means is Mondays would remain in their current state. They'd be odd or even WebEx classes. We'd go over the week, we'd go over the last week and the week ahead, touch bases for all students. Tuesday and Wednesday would be students A through K. So all students A through K would go to their even and their odd classes. Thursday and Friday, all students L through Z would go to their even and odd classes. That's right, with their teachers in person learning. Woo! Yes. Of course, there are going to be some options, some information that we need to get from you. I know that you probably feel like you've been surveyed a million times, but we are going to be sending out a survey. And the reason for that survey is, number one, to determine, again, accurately, who will be returning to campus. It is essential that you fill that out, because if you don't fill that out, we are going to make direct phone calls and confirm whether your student will be returning or opting for a homeschool option. So that's going to be coming out next week. So we're going to be blasting that out, reminding you we need that to be turned around quick. We need that information. Another reason for that is we need to know who will be riding the bus and who will be getting lunches on a daily basis. I should say daily basis when they're here. So whether you're in Fresno, Madera, North Fork, Corscold, O'Neill's, we need to know who's going to be getting on those buses. There's a lot to pull off here because we do have a lot of resources dispersed at the elementary schools in our district. For the COVID regulations, we got to have a lot of staff. So what that means is right now, bus drivers, we're cutting it close. So with this hybrid model, we just got to make sure we have very accurate numbers in order to pull this off. And that goes for food services in the kitchen, custodial, maintenance. So your information is essential. There is some details. If your student decided to stay home for the rest of the year, they would transition completely out of distance learning onto a homeschool format. They'd have 8 classes in a program called Cyber High. and they'd have a teacher making sure they're independently working and making that progress. It's not distance learning. So our options are hybrid model in-person learning or homeschool. Now, determining who would be staying on homeschool is pretty critical for us because that means we have to condense sections and put some of our teachers on homeschool duty, which takes some time. There's a lot of legwork that we have to put in regard to that. So again, please fill out the survey, get us your information. We hope as many people as possible can return to that hybrid. Also, we understand not coming back, but a few things to be aware of is we will have all the regulations in place, including social distancing. We will have masks at all times. When we rotate between classes, we have a very strict regimen where we release from the building two classes at a time. All students move in a clockwise format. Lunches will be separated as far as who's served at one time, and we will separate where kids eat on campus by grade level. A lot of detail, a lot of education that we need to put out to people. We're particularly thinking of our freshmen who have, for the most part, not been on campus. So a lot of work to do in between. That is why, listen to the words carefully, if we're able to return, our target date right now is March 22nd. March 22nd. That is a Monday, which means that technically would be a distance learning day. That's the one day a week we're distance learning. But that Tuesday, we'd start A through K. So our target date right now is March 22nd. No sooner, because we're getting things prepared. Now, if it comes about that it's going to be later, then we need to circle back and reformulate, because we have spring break second week of April. There's a lot of logistics to figure out depending on how late this would go. There is a point when we would not return if it was too late. We would just bring seniors back and a few other isolated cases. So we got to hit that window. We got to be checking on it, monitoring it, but our target date is that March 22nd. We just need your support in listening to these messages, reading the emails that come out. We'll be educating students in the classes. We'll utilize some of those classes to spread the word about what's to be expected. And our staff is ready. All of our staff has been offered vaccinations at this point. And we're feeling good about coming back and seeing our kids and being here with our kids. So we hope you're excited about that too. And lots more to come, lots more announcements. This isn't going to be the only one. We assure you that you're going to be prepared, and we'll offer opportunities for you to ask questions. And we will try to keep everyone as informed as possible as we as a team collectively, you and us and the kids, we get this thing back on track where we all want to be in a safe manner. So we hope you're excited about that. There are possibly some other updates, but I really just want to focus on that for this week's message. And I hope with that word, with that positive news, you guys are as happy as me and you feel like dancing. Never meant to cause you any pain. Only wanted one time to see you laughing. Go pro, go now. I only wanted to see you laughing in the purple rain, purple rain, purple rain, purple rain, purple rain, purple rain.